Hi, my name is Benjamin Sturman.
And my name is Frank Esqui.
And my name is Armando Camacho, and we'll be discussing our gearbox design.
Hi, my name is Benjamin Sturman, and I'll be presenting the background design of gearboxes as well as the background design for our specific project. What is a gearbox? A gearbox is a collection of gears, shafts, and bearings, all used together in an effort to either reduce or accelerate the speed or torque of a drive shaft. All parts are surrounded by an outer casing that is filled with oil or lubricant so as to protect from outside contaminants as well as extend the life of the parts. There is an input and output shaft, and depending upon the application, the angle between the two will vary. What parts are used? Well, first, gears. Bevels, spurs, helical, worm, and planetary gears are all examples of gears that are used within a drive shaft. Shafts themselves, which the gears are mounted on, can be made of various materials, and treatment options are available to aid the strength of the shafts. Bearings. Tapered roller bearings, deep and shallow groove ball bearings, straight roller bearings, and many other types are bearings that are used to support the various shafts that are used within inside the gear system. Oil and lubrication are also used, as well as the gearbox case itself, which protects the entire system from outside contaminants, as mentioned before. Applications of gearboxes. Gearboxes can be used in many fields, such as aerospace, automotive, agricultural, construction, and many others. Specific examples are airplane engines, surgical tables, car engines, helicopters, conveyor belts, or even tractors. Any area, basically, that needs a reduction or acceleration of speed and or torque. Advantages of using a gearbox. Noise reduction and transportability. They have higher efficiencies than traditional open gearing systems. They have much higher reduction ratios in a much smaller area. They have increasing or decreasing output speeds or torques. Very durable and can last much longer than open gearing systems. Disadvantages of a gearbox. They generally cost more to build than other gearing systems. They must be lubricated to run properly. Also, they must use precision gears. The reason why is that without precision gears, the gearing themselves can start to have noise or chatter, which can cause excess vibration and can potentially damage or ruin the system itself. Precision gears and bearings and shafts all cost more money, aka the cost of the entire system goes up. What to consider when designing a gearbox? First, the gear ratios. What is the ratio of gears you need to design and to gain your desired output torque or speed? Gear arrangements need to be made to acquire the desired speed and torque. Also, you have to take into account backlash, vibration, and structural supports that are needed to support the entire system. Our gearbox specifications. Our horsepower to be transmitted is 5.5 horsepower. The input speed is 2,090 RPM. The output speed is 110 RPM. And the input and output direction of the rotating shafts must be opposite, as well as all the shafts must lie within the same plane. And now Frank will continue.
Hello, my name is Frank Esqui, and I'm going to give a general description on our gearbox design. First, we selected the gears from the Boston catalog and found the bending and contact stresses. Next, we found the shafts based upon the bore diameters as well as the forces applied by the gears. We then selected bearings based upon the radial and thrust forces applied on those shafts. Finally, we designed the gear housing based upon the overall geometry of the gear train. The gearbox consists of spur gears and straight bevel gears. That consists of three stages. The first and third stages each consist of two spur gears, and the second consists of two bevel gears. The spur gear ratios are 2.5 to 1. The bevel gear ratios are 3 to 1. All gears are made from cast iron, except for the pinion gear on the bevel gear set, which is made from steel. Here are examples of the gears used based off of the Boston catalog. The pinion consists of 24 teeth, and the gear consists of 60 teeth. Here are the bevel gears selected from the same catalog. The pinion consists of 15 teeth, and the gear consists of 45 teeth. Four shafts were used in the design of this gearbox. All shafts were made of quenched and tempered cold-drawn 4140 steel alloy due to the strength requirements. The second shaft was machined to a smaller diameter to accommodate for the bore diameter differences between two gears. The shafts used have diameters ranging from 0.875 inches to 1.375 inches and various lengths. As previously mentioned, shaft 2 is the only one machined to accommodate the different bore diameters. Four straight roller bearings were used to support the input and output shafts. Four deep groove ball bearings were used to support the second and third shafts. The reason for the use of deep groove ball bearings is to counteract the thrust force produced by the bevel gears. Next, Armando is going to discuss the specific detail, the various loads experienced in the gearbox.
Hello, my name is Armando Camacho, and I'll be discussing in detail our redesign and related calculations. So we did force analysis on the gears using the AGMA procedures, and in the gearing industry, this is the most accurate method to find stresses on gear teeth. As you can see here, we have factor of safeties that are very high, ranging from 2 to 15.93, so we can expect these factors of safety to prevent gear failure. We also did contact, and we see that there are lower, but that's expected because contact stresses are higher in gear teeth. We have values from 1.21 to 2.68, and that is satisfactory for our analysis. For force analysis on shafts, the geometry of the shafts did not change too much, so they kept the same endurance strength. The only thing that changed was the factor of safety. For the first shaft, we had the least amount of torque, so we have a safety factor of 26.24. For the one all the way on the fourth shaft, we have 5.67, and due to the fillet, we have increased torsional stresses, so we have a lower factor of safety. Now for bearings, we have varying stresses, and once again, shaft number 3 posed the most problems as it contained thrust loads from the bevel gears as well as the highest torque. But the cost estimate for the entire system finishes at $1,774. The main expense were the spur gears. 60 teeth each cast iron presents a very large cost to our design. So expected life of a gearbox, assuming operation at 2 hours a day, and 2,090 RPM 5 days a week, we can expect to at least have maintenance done once every 6 months. The bearings and gears are safely rated to at least 10 million cycles, but we expect them to run much more as it is an internal gearbox. The shafts are rated to last indefinitely under fatigue loading, and with a fully lubricated environment, life of the gear set and bearings can exceed well over 100 to 300 million cycles. For maintenance, the gearbox will be filled with lubrication. This reduces the temperature of the overall gearbox and extends the life of the parts used within the gearbox, as well as protecting against humidity. Priority of maintenance for the system will be performed based upon the locations of highest stresses within the gear system, such as shaft numbers 3 and 4 and the last gear set in the gear train system. For our application in the real world, we were going to use a specific gear design where it powers an electric scooter. In this design example, the scooter would be powered by the gear shaft in this lower area, and we can expect 5.5 horsepower, which is more than enough to power the scooter. And this is our video. For this project, the design plan followed was a success. Due to diameter limitations, the shafts were too weak to support the gears. Modifications to a stronger alloy and heat treatment were made to the shafts. The consequence of this was that the price of the shafts went up, but not enough to cause the entire design plan to be altered. And that concludes our presentation.